Nee, noch gar kein Künstler gewesen. Eine komplett neue Karriere also für ihn.
Yeah, now Johnny found that quite interesting and gave Christian a call to find out more about it. Well, how did it all happen?
What were you doing when COVID started?
I was a lecturer at university.
And what are you doing now?
Now I've become a digital visual artist. That is now my full-time job. During lockdown, I had the time to reflect and really think about what I want to do with my life. And I started doing some illustrations, and then I decided, actually, I could do this for a living.
Well, now you're quite successful, to the point that you're regularly featured in newspaper articles, I've seen.
It's weird because, yes, I think there's more interest in it. I think because 2020 has been such a weird year, and I think people just want to hear a good story. I've made the change to fit me, rather than thinking to myself, oh, I can't wait for my life to go back to normal. To me, this is the new normal. This is my new life now.
But what kind of changes to your lifestyle did you have to make?
So I sat down with my partner and we realized that if we wanted to do this and we were very serious about it, we couldn't continue paying rent on a flat. So we decided that we were going to give that up. I was going to move in with my mum and my partner was going to move there with me. I had to be very serious about it in terms of sorting out the financial side of it.
Let's talk a bit about the art. This is radio, so we can't really see it. Could you sort of paint a picture?
I entered a wildlife competition in London, capturing an animal that is on the extinction list. I chose to do a tiger-tailed seahorse. That was really challenging because when you do something abstract, you can kind of just go for it and kind of figure it out later. Well, researching a seahorse, you're almost like learning the anatomy of a seahorse before you have to draw it. And you don't realize how much research you have to do. So I know, you know, all the different parts of a seahorse now. And because my images take up to 50, 60 hours per image, the challenge of that was around time.
What would you say to somebody listening who is inspired by your story, who might want to do something similar?
I would say do the research. I spent at least 2 to 3 months really researching my market, really researching artists that I think are similar to me. I read books. I didn't just wake up one day and think I'm going to become an artist. It's a marathon, not a sprint.
Wow, very interesting man. Wise words there. Former university lecturer, now turned successful digital artist, Christian Azolan. And if you'd like to hear, or let's say rather, see more from Christian, then check him out online at HTTP. That is www.christianazolan.co.uk. And he's also active on all of the usual social media platforms.